Now we are going to start with the topic of relative motion. First we can write down relative motion. We can state that motion of a body as seen from a reference frame which may be at rest or in motion is called relative motion of the body with respect to the frame. Basically, it depends on the frame whether it is at rest or in motion, because we already studied that reference frame is the region from where we take all observations. Like say we are having a body A. It is say moving with a velocity Va, and say Va vector we can write 20 I cap meters per second. It is moving in x direction at a speed of 20 meters per second. And same in x direction, say there is a boy who is standing on a skateboard and he is moving with a velocity Vb. This is the boy B, and say Vb is 13 I cap meters per second. Here we can see that A is moving faster than B, then the separation between them will increase. And here we can see that in 1 second it will travel a distance 20 meter and it will travel a distance 13 meter. So as seen by B, we can say that A has progressed further by a distance of 7 meter. So here we can write relative velocity of A relative to B is, this is written as velocity of A with respect to B, it is written as simply Va minus Vb. So this can be written as 20 I cap minus 13 I cap, this will be 7 I cap meters per second. That is the answer to this question if we are required to find the relative velocity. So here we can say this is the relation which can be used to calculate the relative velocity of one body with respect to other. Mainly you need to subtract the velocity of reference frame from where you are taking the observations. Let's see some more examples based on the logic and we'll study further. We can also state that when we talk about relative motion, it can be written as it is the motion as seen by someone. How a motion appears to someone is called relative motion of the body with respect to that particular observer. And in your earlier chapter also, the basic idea you are having about relative motion, say if there are two bodies A and B, say if the bodies are moving towards each other with the velocity Va and Vb, here we can say if an observer is attached with this body A, we can see that this body A will be the reference frame of observer. So in this situation, velocity of B relative to A can be written as velocity of B relative to A. Vectorially we must write it as Vb minus Va. But in magnitude, if we just have a look, this Vb can be written as negative of Vb because it is moving towards left. Negative of this Va is positive. So this will give us negative of Va plus Vb. That means when A will look at B, it appears that B will be moving towards A with a velocity Va plus Vb towards left, or it is in minus x direction. So always remember, when the body is moving same direction, the relative velocity is the difference of the two. And when the bodies are moving toward each other, the relative velocity will be the sum of two as far as magnitudes are concerned. So we can say in same direction of two bodies, we can simply state the relative speed is equals to V1 minus V2, that is the difference of the two, we are taking the magnitude. And in opposite direction, motion of two bodies when we talk, we can simply state the relative speed can be given as V1 plus V2. We are going to use the situations in various cases. In earlier chapter also, you might have recalled that in few cases, we have used these relations. Let's discuss an example based on relative motion in one dimension. Here it says, on a straight road, cyclists are riding one after other at a separation of 30 meters at a speed of 10 meters per second. If we just parallelly draw the situation, so if these are cyclists which are running one after the other at a separation of 30 meters. So the separation between cyclists is 30 meters. These are cyclists. They are moving at a speed of velocity of cyclists can be written as 10 meters per second. In the same direction, few boys are running at a separation of 20 meters at a speed of 5 meters per second. So there is a boy, another boy is at a distance of 20 meters, another is again at a distance of 20 meters. So the boys are running at a separation of 20 meters. And it is given that they are also moving in the same direction with VB is equals to 5 meters per second. And we are given that an old man is walking in opposite direction. Find his speed so that he'll meet each cycle and boy together. So there is an old man. This old man is walking in the opposite direction, say with a velocity VO. We are required to find the value of this VO so that he'll meet the cyclist and the boy together. So he is located at one point. We can say if old man is considered to be at rest, we find velocity of the next boy and next cyclist with respect to old man. So velocity of cyclist with respect to old man. Velocity of cyclist with respect to old man can be given as they are moving in opposite direction, it will be added. So it can be written as 10 plus VO. And if we talk about the velocity of boy with respect to old man, velocity of boy with respect to old man can be written as 5 plus VO. And as they are going to meet the old man together, that means the time in which the cyclist will cover a distance of 30 meter is exactly the same in which the boy will cover a distance of 20 meter. So we can directly write as time are equal. Time for boy and cyclist to reach old man are equal. This implies we can write 30 divided by 10 plus VO is equals to 20 divided by 5 plus VO. Now you can very easily handle the situation. This will give us 15 plus 3 VO is equals to 20 plus 2 VO. And further on solving, we'll get VO is equals to 5 meters per second. That is the velocity of old man. This is the answer to our question.